What's up, dorks? Welcome back to the channel. After the last time I did a commentary reaction style video, it actually did a lot better than a lot of my previous videos, so we're back with another one. Also, I've gotten active up on my Instagram again, and I'll pop it right here too. So go ahead and follow that and DM me for a shout out. I'm starting to do those every video, so go ahead and do that. And this one is a topic that's going, it's like a smaller part of a bigger video I'm doing later, if that makes sense to what I'm saying. It's been a problem for a while with the rise of technology. Social media has been a problem, but with COVID hitting and schools going virtual and everybody going virtual, it's become a really big problem nowadays. Yeah, we're here to talk about that. And that topic is the idea of cyberbullying and the damage of social media on mental health. I'll do a full, much longer, more in-depth video on cyberbullying and negative impacts of social media later. But today we're just here to talk about a quick video that happened. It was a while ago, but that topic is still relevant nowadays. Basically what happened a couple years ago, I think it was like 3-4 years ago, big YouTuber Jake Paul pulled up on fellow YouTuber Cody Ko and claiming him as a cyberbully, and I've seen a lot of like commentary channels get this kind of rep for being cyberbully, being negative, and I'll go into that a little bit more later with the talk, but right now we're just going to talk about the video itself and the like impacts that it has on people. First thing I noticed is I don't think Jake fully understands why he made this video, if you know what I mean. As we're watching the video, first thing we see is very, very contradictory to his original point. So he's making this video trying to, you know, stop Cody Ko from being negative, stop him being a cyberbully. And the first thing he says is he's gonna fuck his life up.
Bag named Cody Ko, and we are about to fuck his life up.
Now, the crazy part about that is someone of Jake Paul's power can destroy a smaller channel, because Jake Paul is 20 million subscribers versus Cody Ko has 5 million. Jake Paul has 20 million, Cody Ko has 5 million. Jake Paul can really damage Cody's career if he sends his fans on him. And then he also does like the little, maybe not, but maybe, but maybe not, but maybe.
Nah, I'm just kidding. Kind of, not really.
I don't think he knows what cyberbullying is, if you understand what I mean. And there have been links to people calling Jake Paul a bully. I'm not saying he is, but I can see it. You know, the jock bully thing. He fits the description. I'm not saying he is, but I can see why people would say that he is. But it's just an interesting dynamic, and I'll talk about that more later, closer to the end of the video, as to why this instance of him saying this is different than what Cody's going to say later on, but we'll get to that. So the second mistake that Jake Paul has now made, that really kind of kills his whole point here, is he talks about Cody's original career.
28-year-old wannabe comedian Cody Ko, or I saw this Cody Ko guy for the first time when he was working at Full Screen, which is like a YouTube community network, as like a little back-end tech developer.
And does so in a very negative, almost bullying-ish way, because if you didn't know, Cody Ko is a software developer. Well, he's a comedian now, but he went to school at Duke. Keep in mind, he was at Duke, so a big, big university for software development. And he was working at a place called Full Screen, and that's where Jake allegedly first met him. And so he just goes about it saying it's very negative and just not like a good career path. And so that's again kind of undermining his whole campaign here. And we're only 43 seconds in and we have two big red flags. We're not going to watch the full, I'm not going to play the full video because it's 20 minutes. It's a Jake Paul video. We're not doing all that. But I'm just kind of pointing out some of the big things that I'm seeing here and why what I'm saying now is going to come into effect later on when we get closer to the end and I start talking about a couple key concepts when it comes to comedy and commentary and all that.
Shit on the jokes he's made about people. It's just not acceptable.
This is Logan Paul with better hair.
Now that's magic. Oh, wait, what the f*** kind of M. Night Shyamalan ending was that? Bit. This is another absolute classic starting situation right there, folks. You know, when you're juggling your soccer ball alone.
You gotta move on.
Oh, Jesus f***ing Christ. You know this is not comedy. You can do this with anything.
I'm not really sure if that's the right thing. And he's like, come on, just do it. It's not a big deal.
Who the f*** do you want to date?
I'll have my daily dose of vitamins, and I'll make a couple of these health drinks.
Camus powder?
Oh, dude, you're drinking cum powder?
He's just a ball of hatred that has...
So the first thing you'll notice is I took his video, all his examples. That's not taken out of context. That is ripped straight from the video, starting with where he says here's some examples to where he ends it. And so I'm not chopping it up to try to make him look bad. These are all the examples he chose. And one thing you'll notice, they're all bigger channels than Cody Ko, or they're all sizable channels. So, as I said, that's going to come into the power dynamic is going to come in later. But one, they're all sizable. And two, the editor must not know what he's doing because, one, those clips are taken very out of context. Very out of context. Like the girl defined, I will want to say this real quick at the start of the video. I have become a fan of Cody Ko recently. I've watched a lot of his videos. Him and Noelle Miller are two of the people I watch the most right now. So this isn't biased. But as I was saying, the girl defined one, which was those two girls when he was talking about who do you want to like date or whatever. That clip was taken so out of context just to make him look bad. That there was a lot leading up to that joke that you have to watch to understand the joke. Like, it's a funny video, but you can't just take random clips and take them out of context. And that last one with the morning routine, the Camus powder or whatever, that's still a funny joke, even out of context. Like, he's not being negative to anybody. He's making a joke about... Sorry about my neighbors, guys. Same neighbors that got arrested last time. But anyway, like, it's still a funny joke on its own. I don't understand how taking it out of context is to suit his favor. Like, it's still a funny joke. I mean, he just hurts himself by putting that in there. But let's watch the actual... Now, okay. Fast forward to the actual exchange and... So, the way this is set up is Cody Ko was on this Jeff's Barber interview thing where, like, he gives you a haircut and he interviews you while you're on the air thing. He's known for, like, bringing surprises and gags in. And when Cody was on the show, he brought Jake Paul on. And, yeah, I'll play the clip real quick just to show you, like, how the interaction went. I'm not going to take it out of context. Keep in mind, this is all Jake's video. I'm not taking anything out of context from his video. For a video like this, context is very important, and I want to leave everything in context so you get like the full picture.
What's up, man? Are you trying to find me?
What up, fam?
Be nice.
I don't
want to
fight.
I'm
not
going
to do that again.
Sit down.
No, do it again.
Come in, but
Come in what? Nicer?
Come in nicer, dude. You don't care.
You're cyberbullying kids, bro.
Kids?
You're cyberbullying kids, bro. I don't like that.
Which kids?
I don't like cyberbullies, and you're a cyberbully.
I'm sorry, man.
Hey, man.
You said sorry. That's good.
Yeah.
I'm sorry for bullying you.
No, it's not okay, but like.
The first thing you'll notice here, I forgot to cut, but I'll. The first thing you'll notice here is. Even Jeff wasn't expecting him to come in with quite that level of aggression that he did. He even tells him to come back and start it again.
No, do that again. Sit down.
No, do it again.
Come in nicer.
And you look at Cody, you can tell Cody has no idea what's going on. He doesn't realize Jake Paul's here to intimidate him, to confront him. He doesn't know what's going on. Jeff didn't know what was going on. So... I don't think, and as I said at the beginning, I don't even think Jake Paul knows what's going on. Alright, so, and when he comes to actually confront him for the cyberbullying allegations, He brings up that he knows personally girls who have been affected by Cody Ko.
It's out there, like, I've met girls who you've, like, gone in on.
But when Cody Ko, in very earnest to try to fix things, asks Jake Paul who they are to, like, try to fix it, to try to make up for it, because one thing you'll find out if you, like, actually watch Cody Ko is if he sees, like, a joke is too much, he'll go back and try to rectify the situation. And Jake Paul doesn't have any substantial evidence to back up those claims.
And, like, I don't f*** with it. I don't need to bring up their names to cause drama for them.
So it just falls kind of flat because he has no evidence. So it just comes really awkward. And again, with when I said he doesn't know what he's there for, he follows it up by saying you're actually funny.
Yeah, you're hilarious, bro. Like, you're hilarious. That's not what anyone's debating.
Like, he's a funny guy. And it's just, it comes across very, I don't know, very conflicted as to what the true point of this video is. And especially at the end, like, it looks like we're all good. Cody obviously apologized. Even since he didn't know what he did, he still apologizes.
I'm sorry.
Hey, man.
You said sorry, that's good.
Yeah.
I'm sorry for bullying you.
But if you look at the end of the video, no progress was made.
He didn't really seem like he was trying to budge. Like, you were pretty understanding, you know? And you were trying to, like, find, like, a new perspective, and I don't think he was really open to that.
No, yeah.
He was just kind of
instantly get scared, like, I don't want to fight. Like, these cyber bullies, like, but if you watch the way he is on his videos, it's like, homies, like, if he was saying that shit to someone in front of their face, like, he would get knocked out.
And a couple of tweets from Jake Paul also show that no progress was made, so the whole point of the video just kind of falls flat on its face. And this is where I get into the real problem at the root of this whole situation. So, the real problem at hand is, yes, cyberbullying is a thing. And cyberbullying does affect people. Like, that's a real thing. And commentary channels and comedy tiptoe a very fine line of bullying and comedy. They're like, there's a very fine line. The point where it crosses that fine line is a term known as punching down, where a smaller party, a smaller victim, whatever, is the butt of the joke. Like, let's say Cody Ko was to go make a joke about an individual girl who didn't have a following. Yes, that is bullying because she has no grounds to stand on. But the thing that's happening here is he's making jokes about bigger channels. 5 Minute Crafts is a content farm with tens of hundreds of employees. They're not negatively impacted, and they're not vulnerable. They're not feeling hurt. The actual definition of bullying is, let's go pull up the actual definition of bullying. So the actual definition of bullying is to seek to harm, intimidate, or coerce someone perceived as vulnerable. And a person with 20 million followers, not saying Jake Paul isn't vulnerable, because at the end of the day, he's still human, he still has feelings. But the thing is, you have to realize that when you have a platform that size, you're going to receive criticism, and he's mistaking criticism as bullying for, like, the jokes against him and all that. He's mistaking criticism as bullying, and that's, you can't cross that line. And the problem is, Jake Paul crosses that line too many times. And as I said, with the punching down, Cody never punches down on people. He attacks bigger or similar sized platforms. And at that point, the vulnerability, you kind of have to be prepared for that when you have a platform that size. So this whole thing is just very, I don't want to say tasteless, because the idea of the video is right. Like, the cyberbullying is a real problem, but cyberbullying Jake Paul isn't the problem. Cyberbullying Dre Drexler isn't the problem. Cyberbullying Logan Paul is not the problem. Cyberbullying these Instagram comedians, that's not the problem, because at the end of the day, a lot of those people don't get hurt by these videos. And Jake Paul making it seem like they are when they're not. It's false claims that are coming off as true. And that's the problem with comedy and all that, is people don't understand that fine line, and a lot of people go overboard. But then, because so many people go overboard, people look at people that aren't overboard, that are doing comedy and are taking it too far. And that's the big problem with this video. So, in conclusion, just a few closing thoughts here as we wrap up the video. I will be making a longer, more scripted, more structured video on cyberbullying, the negative impacts of social media, my experiences with it. It'll be a long, much longer, like maybe an hour long. I don't know. Just throwing out a time out there, but like it'll be a full developed video. I'm gonna be working for like about a month on it, researching, making little bits and pieces here and there. But the thing is, cyberbullying is a very real problem. But here, it's a case of somebody was criticized and not knowing how to handle the criticism. When you have a 20 million subscriber platform and you're not able to handle criticism, then that becomes a problem, because we can no longer keep people in check. Criticism is made to keep people with power in check. That's why you criticize government officials. That's made to keep people in power in check. And if we don't criticize those people, or if it gets to where our criticism is being taken as bullying, then those platforms can no longer be held accountable. And that's when the power goes to their head and we start to have problems. So I don't want this to be a negative video, but I know it's an old thing, but it's something that I feel very strongly about. Something that I wanted to, I know this whole thing was 2 years ago, but it's just something I feel strongly about. And it's a good like segue into this next video that I'm working on. It's a good, I don't know how to explain it, like a good setting the stage a little bit for this much more in-depth video that I'm working on. So yeah, this was just a quick one. Again, closing thoughts: cyberbullying's a problem, but don't confuse it as criticism. Do not cross criticism and bullying, because both are very, very different things. And we need to, as a society, we need to start learning the difference between criticism and bullying. And that's where this whole problem stemmed from, was people not knowing the difference between comedy, criticism, and bullying. So, hope you guys enjoyed. I know it was a long video. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Bitch, why you ain't asking that phone? What's wrong? I've been calling all goddamn night. It's 5 o'clock. Girl, it's time to come home. But you trying to be wrong? Bitch, let a nigga know. The hoes love me like a coke. No handcuffs, bitch, let a nigga go. Bitch, I'm gone from the O. I'm trying to talk to your soul. Gotta